and welcome to another Super Mario Master Brothers video here on the Lulu's Trader Games channel. Today I want to discuss about the newcomers to Smash, the Inklings. Now I'm not going to discuss moveset since it's more than likely to be based off of Splatoon 2 and I haven't had the chance to play it yet, so I cannot really say for sure for the moveset. However, I do know enough about, I have played Splatoon 1 and seen enough of Splatoon 2 to get an idea of what they should do for the stage. So as you know, both games are hosted by four different characters. Splatoon 1 is hosted by the Squid Sisters and Splatoon 2 is hosted by the Octahook. Amber Square, whatever you call them. And this actually seems off of, I was looking at a website, they were talking about the current characters that you can see in the shadows. They were like, well, people would probably rather play as Pearl Marina than the Inkling. And we're looking, you know, speak for the entire fan base and be like, oh, this is true, or this isn't true. But Marina are not good representatives of the entire franchise. The Inklings are much better representatives. And, they're playable in both games, they're main characters. I don't really need to go much into detail. But here's a simple thing. But Marina don't appear in the first game. The Squid Sisters do. So there's that. Of course you'd be like, well, Ness from Earthbound didn't appear in the first mother game, but he's a reference to the characters. Well, here's the funny thing about Ness. His game was the only mother game in America around the time that Original Smash came out. So it was the only one to really know about. Now you can then go and talk about Lucas, but I think he just follows the same role that Martin Boyd did. That he was added despite not having a game in America. Though oddly enough, he didn't have his game released in America like Martin Boyd did. Oh well, whatever. That's not what I discussed. Since Pearl and Marina are in the new games and there's more likely for kids to recognize them, especially now, over to Squid Sisters, unless you know they play the story mode and I don't know, but Pearl and Marina would be more recognizable. So what I think they should do, but the Inkling is the level. Just like what they did with Star Fox. Just like what they did with Kid Icarus. They should have a secret taunt thing where Pearl Marina will come and talk about the character you were battling. It would be fitting for what they do. And again, because they discuss and commentate on stage battles and Sparkfest and whatnot. So I feel like it's more fitting for them to do. So, and what's even better for Pearl Marina is that unlike with the Kid Icarus game, where they had to put voice text over the other characters, that was set up with they just stuck in sample tags. Like, oh, we don't know, but to make it easier on the voice actors not to come back and do voice every single time, they added a new DLC character. And it was very dull, because all the DLC characters tend to be released either real close together or at the same time. And it would have just been too much for the voice actors. Luckily, for Pearl Marina and the Squid Sisters, they don't have you know, actor voice and the language speaking isn't really translatable. So all Nathan will need to do is add these characters. They just have to put the same language over it. And then just put text over it. Seems simple enough, right? So I feel like they should just use them to. Of course, the Swiss should join in with them sometime. That should be really awesome. I mean, seeing what they think and commentate about the other characters. Remember, it was funny in the kid this one. With it, and I mean, in the kid this one, they had different characters join in. So, I mean, why not? I mean, honestly, I think that's all they should really do with women. Well, I can't say for sure, you know, if one more of the players, I feel like the things are definitely the right choices for the characters to represent the Splatoon. But probably there should definitely be a continuation on the categories and Star Fox Easter egg. Now, while they should replace the Kid Icarus Easter egg with the Splatoon one, the Star Fox one, since it's not anywhere the same, it's really just a bunch of different characters coming together, talking to each other, and rather than discussing who they're fighting against, I think, yeah, they end up listening. But the Kid Icarus one has replaced. I mean, the Kid Icarus is pretty much replaced the Snake Kodak thing from Brawl, so I think it's time to replace with Splatoon. And like I said, it'd be easier on the voice actors if they use Homer instead of Pet or Quarantine or Tiny Girl, I can't remember her name. Yeah, but that's all I want to discuss about this. If you have any hidden thoughts, let me know. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.